What up, what up? Winbush here. And today I'm excited to say that we can officially run VDBs real-time inside of Unreal Engine 5.3. Now, ever since 5.3 got released, I immediately jumped in to try to figure out VSTs, and I couldn't quite wrap my head around it. A lot of people have tried to help me figure this out. I'm gonna link everybody down below in case you wanna follow those guys. But the person that came through in the end was Philbert, in which I'm gonna show you his setup there that he released on Twitter this morning. Now, you guys might remember, he's the one that made the original VDB plugin for Unreal Engine 5, which I covered last year. So if you wanna check out his plugin and show him some support, make sure you follow him. But this is the only guy right now that I know of that's actually figured out how we can actually use the volumes inside of Unreal Engine 5. And so I'm gonna give you guys a complete breakdown of his material so that you guys can go through and rebuild it on your own. So to get started, we're inside of Unreal Engine 5.3 right now. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag over my Windows Explorer because I have some VDBs in here. Now this is gonna be the cloud pack, so these are static. So I'm just gonna select one at random, left click, drag it into my content browser. And now you can see that we have an open VDB import options window that's gonna open up. I'm gonna leave everything at default here and just click import. And again, this is gonna be a static VDB. Now back in Windows Explorer, this one's the gasoline explosion. So I'm just gonna look for the first frame right here, which is zero. I'm gonna left click, drag this into my content browser. And this one's gonna be a VDB sequence in which it's gonna tell you there's 131 files found here. And then it's gonna actually give you the density, temperature, and flames that's involved inside of this VDB here. So I'm gonna leave everything again here at default. I'm just gonna click import. And once that's imported, if you actually hover over it, you can see at the top right there, it's gonna say it's a sparse volume texture, in which if you just wanted to test these out, we can actually do so by making sure you click on the uppermost folder down here inside of your content browser. And inside my search, I'm just gonna type in sparse volume texture viewer. So that's gonna be your sparse volume texture viewer. And you'll see this little icon right here. If you left click and drag this into your scene here, this is actually gonna be just a viewer. So we're not gonna be able to control anything in here. All you could do is click and drag your VDBs into this just to kind of view them and see how they play out. So let me exit this out here. So making sure I have this selected, I'm gonna come down here to my details panel. And right here under asset preview, I'm gonna left click on my cloud, drag it into here. And now you can see we have our cloud mesh in here, or not mesh, but VDB. So it's just giving you a preview of what it should look like. And we can also do animated versions as well. So if I do my gasoline explosion, left click, drag it in here, we don't see anything yet. And because this is an animated VDB, so down here in the lower right hand side, you should see animate. So if I click on this, now we can see the VDB playing real time inside of our viewport. But again, this is just a viewer. This isn't gonna give us any type of temperature or density or black bodies that we need to be able to really see this. And so for that, we're gonna have to build the material from scratch. Now I'm gonna take you guys step by step with all the nodes. I'm gonna go slow here just so you can see exactly what you need to put in there, because there's quite a few nodes in there. And then also I'm gonna link down below the Twitter post to where Theobald actually gave a screenshot of everything, just in case you wanna go back for reference. But again, I'm gonna go through node by node so you know exactly where to put everything and how to connect it. So I'm gonna come over here. I'm actually going to delete my texture viewer like so. And I'm just gonna save everything just to have it saved. And then once it's saved out, I'm just going to right click and I'm going to come over here to material. I can actually just name this one cloud for right now, like so. And then I'm going to double click on it and we're going to make this full screen so we can see it better. And I'm just going to come over here to where we have this node. It's going to be called cloud or whatever you named it. And the first thing we want to do is come down here to material where it says material domain. Instead of surface, we want to make this a volume. Now under the blend mode, instead of opaque, we actually want to make this one additive. And this is going to be where we start off at. So from here, I'm just going to come into blank space here. I'm going to hold down the 3 on my keyboard and left click. And that's going to bring up our constant variable 3 here, in which we could just left click, bring this into our albedo. And we can actually make the color white. So I'm just going to drag this up. We're just going to have it default be white. And then once we do that, I'm going to right click on this and convert it to a parameter. And what I'm going to name this parameter is scattering color. Now, the reason I made this a parameter is because we're going to make this a material instance later. And so a lot of these are going to make parameters so we can control these later on in our instance material. Now, moving on from here, I'm going to come down to emissive color. I'm going to left click this out and then I'm just going to type in multiply. And right here under math, I'm going to select multiply like so. And then right here under B, I'm going to left click, drag this out. and I'm going to name this one scalar, and I'm going to look for scalar parameters, in which I'm going to left click that one right there, and I'm going to name this one black body parameter, like so. And then for my default value, you can either do it in here or in the details panel. I'm going to do it in the details panel, but for my default value, I'm just going to make this one one, and I'm just going to click save just to save everything we did. Now I'm going to hold M on my keyboard. That's a shortcut for multiply. So hold down M, left click right here, and this is going to add another multiplier here. And then I'm going to connect this multiplier with this multiplier right here. But first I'm going to right click, and I'm going to look for black body under utility. Left click that right there, and I'm going to connect this with a black body there. So I'm going to connect this multiplier to the temperature right here and to the A slot right here. And then we're going to make another scalar property. So I'm going to right click again, just look for scalar parameter. And I'm going to name this one temp multiplier. And then I'm actually going to put this one into the B slot. And I'm going to have a value of this one at one. Now for the A slot, I can actually left click this out, and I'm going to look for a remap value range, in which once I type out remap, you should see it right here under math. So I'm going to left click on this one here, and you see an error, but don't worry, we'll get this situated here in a moment. I'm going to make sure that this is connected to the A slot. So just to reiterate, I'm going to pull back here a little bit just so you can see what's going on. So I have my scatter color here under the albedo, emissive color, I have a multiplier connected to a black body parameter, which is a scalar parameter. And we have the A slot connected to a black body temperature slot. Right here is connected to another multiplier that's connected to a scalar node right here at the default.1. And then the latest thing we just did, remap volume range, in which we're going to continue from here. Now I'm going to slide this over a little bit. I'm going to right click, and we're going to add a couple more scalar parameters. So I'm just going to add this here. And I'm actually going to select this one, Control C to copy, then Control V to paste it. I'm going to paste it a few more times, like so. So we want to have four overall. So I'm just going to connect this to the input low. I'm going to connect this one to the input high. This one right here connected to target low. And then this one right here, I'm going to connect it to target high. And now I'm going to come through and rename all my parameters here so I know what's what inside of our material instance. So for this top one, I'm just going to name this one remap input low. And for this one, I'm going to name this one remap input high. For this one here, I'm going to name this one remap target low. And then this one right here, I'm going to name this one remap target high. Now let me push in a little bit just so you can see a little bit better what's going on here. So I'm going to put these up here like so, just so you can see what's happening. So actually I spelled this one wrong right here. So it should be remap input low, remap input high, remap target low, and remap target high. And then you're just going to connect it with the input low, input high, target low, target high. Now for my input high, I'm going to make this a default value of one. And then for my remap target high down here at the bottom, I'm going to make this one a default value of one as well. So once we do that, again, I'm just going to click on save. This error is going to pop up, but that's okay. I just want to make sure to save our progress. And I'm going to scroll back here just a little bit because we're going to add a mask here now. So I'm going to right click, type in mask. And right here where it says component mask, I'm going to left click on this one. And now we have a component mask. So I'm going to move these down a little bit here. I'm going to move my mask over here. And right here inside of our details panel, where it says RGBA, I'm actually going to have it just go through the green mask right here, like so. So we only have the green one selected, which is the G. Now we want to connect this to the input right here where it says remap values, but I'm going to follow exactly how Thalebuilt did it. And so I'm going to connect these two between a reroute, in which Brandon Clemens helped me figure this one out. So I'm going to right click right here, type in reroute, add reroute node, left click there. And then I'm going to right click on it, convert named reroute. I'm going to select this right here. And then I'm going to name this one just temp, T-E-M-P. And then I'm going to connect my mask to this input right here. Connect this one to this input right here. And then for my color node, I'm just going to make this one green because that's exactly how Thalebuilt had it. So I just want to copy exactly what he did there. And we have an error message pop up here in which I'm going to right click right here. And this is where we're going to bring in our sparse volume. So I'm going to type in sparse. And once you do, it should be under textures. We want to use this one right here, the sparse volume texture sample parameter. So I'm going to left click on this. And then for my A attributes, I'm going to connect it to my G mask right here, like so. That's going to make the air go away. And let me pull back here a little bit just so we can see what's going on again. So again, I'm going to tag everything in Twitter so you guys can see it a little bit better. But Hopefully you guys are following along. I know it seems like it's a lot, but it's actually not once you follow through with the tutorial here. Everything's pretty easy to follow along with. So I'm going to drag this down a little bit, and let's actually go with the UVs right here. So I'm going to scroll in here a little bit, and I'm actually going to scroll this out, click and drag on a node, and I'm going to look for a divide node, which we have right here. So that's going to be connected to the UVs right there. And then inside of my A node, I'm going to left click, drag this out. I'm going to look for subtract, which is also going to be under the math node right here. So I'm going to click on subtract, pull this out a little bit. So now you can see we have subtract connected to a divide node inside the A slot. So under my subtract, I'm actually going to left click, pull this out, and I'm going to look for local position, which we have right here under miscellaneous. So I'm going to left click on this right here. And we don't need to do anything else. Just make sure local position is connected to the A right here. And then just in a blank area down here, I'm just going to right click. And I'm going to type in object local. And once you do, you should see object local bounds like so. So I'm going to left click on this. And right here where it says extents, I'm going to connect this to the divide in the B slot. And right here where it says minimum, I'm going to connect this here to the B slot of the subtract. Now this is all you're going to have to do for the UVs. So just take a look at it again. We have local position. We have object local bounds. They're both connected to a subtract and the divide. That's going to go to our sparse volume textures parameters right here, all through the UVs. So moving on from here, let's set up the density, in which, let me scroll out so you can see it a little bit better. So this is how our material is looking right now. So right now we're going to set up our density. So let me scroll back down here to open area. I'm going to right click, type mask, and I'm going to make another component mask. But for this one, I'm actually going to have the red selected. So in my details panel, I just want to have the R check mark like so. And then I'm going to connect this one to my attributes A as well. Because remember, when we imported it, all of our attributes were inside the attributes A slot. I don't remember anything being in attribute B, so we don't need to connect anything there. And then I'm going to make another reroute node. So I'm just going to right click, type in reroute, add reroute node. Then I'm going to right click on it, convert to name reroute. And then I'm going to name this one density. And I believe he did this just so he could kind of keep track of what everything is right here. So under my node color, I'm going to copy what he had. I'm going to go with purple as well. Click OK. Then I'm going to make another scalar. So I'm going to right click down here, type in scalar, look for scalar parameter right here. And then I'm going to name this one density, mult, M-U-L-T. And then I'm going to have the default value at 1. Now to connect these together, I'm going to look for multiply. So I'm just going to hold down M on my keyboard. Actually, I'm just going to right click, type in multiply, just so you guys can see it. So right here under math, I have multiply. Then I'm going to connect my density reroute to the A slot. And then my density mult, I'm going to connect this one to the B slot like so. So this is pretty much going to finish it off. So my multiply right here, I'm going to connect this to the extension like so. And now we have everything connected. So just pulling back, this is exactly what it looks like here. So hopefully I went slow enough for you guys to be able to follow through and have everything connected. But I know it looks like a lot, but it actually is not. There's a lot of scalar parameters in here, and it's just about connecting everything where it needs to go. Now, the last thing we need to do is actually come in here where we have our sparse volume texture. I'm going to left click on this. If you look down in the details panel down here, this is where we have our sparse volume texture that we can actually drag our VDB or our VST into. So if I select this right here, you can actually see the VDBs that we actually brought in. So I'm going to start off with the cloud one. I'm going to left click on this. And now we have our cloud VDB connected to our material. So I'm actually going to just save this out now. And then I'm going to exit this out. And right here where I have my cloud material that we just made, I'm going to right click on this. And then I'm going to come under here where it says create material instance. I'm going to left click on this. And now we have an instance of that material. So I'm going to save all just to make sure it's all saved. And if I double click on it, now you can see that we have attributes box for everything that we have as parameters in there. And so this will make it easier to go through and kind of mix around with some stuff instead of going back to the material itself. So let me actually make this a little bit smaller because we have to add one more thing to be able to see our VDB. Now I'm not even sure how to pronounce this next thing, so we're actually just going to look for it. So I'm going to come up here to where it says quickly add the project. I'm going to left click on this. Come down to the bottom where it says place actors panel. I'm going to left click on this, and inside the search bar, I'm just going to type in HET. And that's going to bring up this volume right here. Again, I'm not even sure how to really pronounce it. So I'm just going to say H volume. I'm going to left click, bring it into my scene here. Then I can exit this out. And then if I look, let me actually move this off my screen for right now, but it looks like a little dinosaur icon or a dragon or something. And so this is what we're going to be able to bring our material into. So over here in my details panel with my H volume selected, I'm just going to drag this up. And right here in the material slot, I'm going to bring my material instance right into here. So there we go. Now you can see we have our VDB cloud in here. It's going to look a little bit weird. So what you need to do is come under your transform and actually just move these out a little bit. So maybe let's make this 2x3, somewhere around there. You're just going to have to play with the scale a little bit until you can find something that you want. And then I'm bringing over my material instance right here. And let's look at maybe like the black body parameter. So let's bring this up to like 10. And then for my density multiplier, maybe let's bring this down, make it a little bit thinner there. So you can mess around with these until you can find something that looks good for your scene or your VDB there. But that's how a static VDB is going to look. Now, let's say we want to have like our animated one, like an explosion or something. So I'm just going to actually reset these. I'm going to come back down here. And where we have our original material that we made our cloud, I'm just going to left click, drag this over, and then I'm going to copy it. So I'm just going to left click, copy, and then let's rename this one, maybe explosion. And then I'm going to double click on this one. And that's going to bring up our window here again. So this is a copy of the material that we just made. And we're going to look for a sparse volume texture. I'm going to left click on this one. And where we have our cloud down here in the lower left hand corner, I'm going to left click and let's pick the gasoline explosion. So I'm going to select this one and then I'm going to save it. Now I can exit it out. And then I'm going to right click on it and make a material instance of this one as well. So now we have a material instance for our explosion. Now with my H volume still selected, I'm just going to click and drag it into here. And then I could double click this to bring this window open so we can see all the properties and everything. But you can see right now, we don't have anything inside of our viewport. And that's because we need to tell it that it's animated. So in my H volume selected here, I'm actually going to come down and look for right here under volume, we have animation. So I'm going to select this. And now you can see we have our explosion in there, in which it's a little bit stretched. So for this one, I'm actually going to do 111, in which there we go. So I can actually scale this up in unison by 2. So each of these VDBs, you're just going to have to play around with the scale until you find something that works for you. And then also, if you look down here, we have frame rate as well. I'm not sure the frame rate that this one was built in, but maybe let's bring this up to like 30. Gives us a little bit better explosion. I'm not sure the frame rate it was built at, but let's actually go through and play with some of the attributes here and getting this looking like an explosion. So right here under black body parameters, I'm going to select this. And my temperature multiplier that I created too, maybe let's bring this up to like 5,000. Now you can see we're starting to get some of that explosion in there. Maybe the black body parameter, bring this one up to 10, see what that one looks like. And then also for our scattering color, because we made a parameter for that, I'm going to left click on this one. And we can also change the color out as well. So let's say you want to make it a little bit purplish there on the smoke. Or if you want it to be a little bit more realistic with it, you can always make it gray, somewhere around there. So you can always play around with the colors as well. But this is how we could get our explosion and play around with the color parameters, our temperature multiplier, and also our black body parameters. And maybe let's see what the density multiplier is going to do. So if I bring this down to 1, this is going to give us a little bit more of like a flame look. So you can see with the textures and everything, this could be really powerful, and this is all running real time instead of Unreal Engine. Now, I know this one went a little bit long, but I wanted to make sure that you guys were able to build out the material that you need to be able to view the VST VDBs inside of Unreal Engine. Again, big shout out to Theobald. He shared with me his material structure there. So we have to give him a major thank you, because without him, I'll probably still be banging my head against the wall trying to figure this out. But I also want to say thank you to Logan, aka Hollowoodsman, that tried to help me figure this out. Brandon Clemens, who helped me figure this out a little bit. And also Dylan there on Twitter. Without the help of the community, I would have never been able to figure this out. So hopefully this helps you guys figure it out and you can pay it forward. So if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. And as always, stay fresh, keep creating, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Thank you.